So, welcome to Rabbi Dr. Michael Roshinsky, the Charles University in Prague, Faculty of Humanities. Thank you very much for being here.
And shalom, and I am very happy to come here with the framework of the course of my very old friend, and friend from the music, Jewish music point of view. This is how I met your lecturer, Dr. Veronica Seidlova, and we worked on some project together before, and now I have the honor to invite her to the conferences of world cantors, top people of Jewish synagogue music, to lecture there. She already did it for me in the conference which I organized with the University of London here in Prague, already two times, in 2016 and in 2018, November, just last year. I don't know when I will do the next one here, but the first time we went together, it was in 2009, which means more than 10 years ago, to a conference in which we shared a lecture on a record which Veronica made on a Jewish cantorial music. That's exactly our lecture today, music of the real synagogue. I want just to say some statement. You know, when people talk about Jewish music, and I'm talking like people of the Jewish community even, that most of them did not grow in any religious atmosphere or in any daily service or in the synagogue or in even every yearly service in the synagogue. So from them, Jewish culture is not the culture of the synagogue, but this is where it all starts. Yeah, even Jacques Offenbach or Alevi, who wrote a very important opera which is called La Juive. Okay, just write down Rachel, Alevi, Halevi, La Juive, the Jewish. Lady, it's a very famous opera. Every tenor wants to sing that one, even Caruso. So you are a musician, so you should know about it. So they were sons of cantors, and they came to the world of Europe, but they were sons of cantors in the synagogue. So this is where it all started. Mahler had a bar mitzvah before he Christianized himself to become something in the world in Vienna. Yeah? Gustav Mahler. His name was not Gustav, it was like Moshe or something like that. Yeah? You understand what I mean? So that's it. So this is what you are going to get from me here, but only a little bit on the from here. And we are going to do it together because we already did something last week. And I sang with you and you get into the atmosphere. So today, what I will show you, it's something about the cycle of the Jewish year, for which I made some concerts in memory of the synagogue which was destroyed in Olomouc 2 years ago. And there are some pieces, and it's written even where do we sing them in Czech. But I'm not doing this one yet. If we have time, we'll do it in the second half of my presentation. But I showed it you here because that was like the cycle of the Jewish year, because it was in the moment of the Olomouc synagogue, which if you look here, the date that it was standing, one of the most beautiful synagogues, it was only from 1897, and you see when it was destroyed. So it's less than 40 years. Now the Jews, it took them years to collect the money and to build it in the centrum of the town. They were proud of being rich. You know, some people say, you are a Jew, you must be rich. I said, yes, I wish so, you know. And some people say, this is anti-Semitic kind of saying. Yeah, because everyone wants to be rich. You are a Jew, you are after money. Yes, I am after money. But I also give a lot of money to charity and to many other things. So we are not, They collected the money and built the synagogue. My grandfather collected money. He was a rabbi, same name, Dushinsky Mikhail, in Budapest. Now it's Budapest 15. Then it was outside Budapest, like Prague, yeah? And it was a suburb where Jews come and live. And he built the synagogue only in 1926-7. I have the dinner, the little benchel, you know, with the blessings that they gave with the Hungarian instructions, you know, every blessing, Jews sees many, many blessings every day, which they gave for the dinner with the collected money in 1926. So they built it after, that was the collecting of the money, dinner, you know. And then it's empty now, it's not destroyed, it's empty and it's a Hungarian library. My grandfather built it with his community. So when I made this, they asked me to give some a concert. I made it solo a cappella, like I do it here with you, without any music. And I was singing, and I managed to sing with all the people who were there many of these pieces. You know, I sang solo, but they joined me. So during the cycle of the year, we have services. Jews are obliged to pray in the synagogue or privately every day three times. Morning service, not five times like Muslims, only three. Morning, and this takes a bit longer, half hour minimum, and you put the tefillin and the talit, which you saw me last week. And afternoon service, which is before dark, you can start after lunchtime, 1 hour after midday, after zenith, you know, until evening, and evening service every day. And it doesn't matter if it's weekday or Shabbat, Saturday, we start Friday night, or any other of the holidays, which some of them we will mention. The formula of the prayer is almost as the same every day. So it's getting bored to pray every day the same thing. Yes. Okay, so you see many people have this. I want you to take, you can take a photo and see this. Here you have with English, quite modern, with a translation of Rabbi Lord. What is the name of this Lord? You know his name, Jonathan. Here he would still serve, you see? When he made it, he was only serve. Then the queen came again, made him again like this. You know how it goes. You know? And she made him a Lord. Okay? So here was only Ser when he made this CWC English. And the big surprise is that some of the friends, and this lady knows of them very well, they are good friends, like Jakob Schwab and others, they made a Sidur. And this is already a second Sidur. Sidur means the order of prayers. You must remember this word, this will be in the test. Sidur, okay? So go around, this is Sidur in Czech. So all of them are the same. All of them are the same. And you see, if you look at the content, you see morning prayer, evening prayer, Shabbat prayer, and festival prayers, and so on. So you want me to stand in one place usually? Okay, I will try to. No, but it doesn't matter. And at one or two stages, please show the class also. Please, yeah? Or follow me when I move. Thank you. No, because it's important to see how you are looking like this. What is coming next? Okay, so next is daily prayer. Daily prayer, yeah, not so many people come. Most people come on Shabbat. But on daily prayer, there are. If you go to a synagogue in many places in Israel, in Czech Republic a bit less, but if you go to the kosher hotel, King David, tourists who are coming here, there is a synagogue down, every day, it's full. I can show you a picture from a few weeks ago. Took from the back, all of them with the talit, you know, on their backs. Pray. And it took a long time, this morning prayer. And, please move this sidurim plural. Move it among the people that they will... I'm sorry, it's not my fault. No, I already almost fell when I sat on it. But it's okay. And So, cycle of the Jewish year. So here you say with me, Baruch Hu et Adonai Mevorach. So, Bakasha, Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamvorach. Somebody please read this. One of you. Okay. Every one of this one. And the community, or if there is choir, of course, the choir, please, Baruch,
Baruch.
Adonai,
Adonai.
Hamvorach,
Hamvorach.
Le'olam,
Le'olam.
Vaed. Now, you see, I made some of them like this. In phonetics, this is the sound of A, E, I mean the consonant, the Somu, Su, Solaski. The solaska is the consonant. The solaska a, and this one, the opposite is the solaska a. Can you make a? A. A.
A.
A. You've got to learn Arabic, because then you will have to learn two different a's. Yeah, you know, different language. But in Judaism, in Hebrew, we also have it. But most of Ashkenazi Jews cannot pronounce the difference between a and a, but at least I marked it for you, so you, it's exactly Baruch Hu. And what is the meaning of this, please? And then the cantor, or the one who said it, he repeats it. What? And why he has to repeat it loudly? Because, for example, I'll say, and everyone after me with the music, Baruch Hu Et Adonai Hamvorach, Hu Et
Adonai
Hamvorach. Okay, and then everyone, one is saying it usually, yeah, like cantor or the one who leads the service, and then the community who is around, and you need minimum 9-10 men above bar mitzvah. Bar mitzvah means when he's 13 and one day, who have to be there to form. And it's called minyan. You must remember this word too, minyan. And the people are around him, and it can be 100 or 2,000, it doesn't matter, or just 9 people. He says, Baruch Hu et Adonai Mevorach, and they must say, he says to them, do it, yeah, bless God. So they bless, and they say, Ospodim Rabba, Baruch Adonai, please.
Baruch Adonai.
Hamvorach.
Hamvorach.
Le'olam Vaed.
Le'olam
Vaed. It draws you to continue. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Amin Benatananu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah. Amen. Please. Ta ta ta. Amen. That's the Baruch Hu, which you even don't know what I'm talking about. It's not the cycle of the year. It's all year round. This is the Baruch Hu, which every little boy who is going first time up to the Torah, which is in his bar mitzvah, this is the nusach for this Baruch Hu. Yeah? That's the Baruch Hu of bar mitzvah. But every week, twice, we are taking the Torah and we read it. Everyone who comes to read up the Torah says, Baruch Hu et Adonai, Amevorach. So this is the first one which you learn, because this is international. And everyone who even is not religious at all, usually make bar mitzvah. So at least this one he knows. He doesn't know the one which I will teach you later. Because he doesn't come on Friday night. He's not religious. He's going to the sea. He's going to the pub. Are you with me? Especially Shabbat morning. Better to sleep. Why should go to the synagogue, wake up at 8 o'clock, at 9 o'clock? This is our Sunday. The Shabbat is our Sunday. Sunday you want to sleep, no? Going to the synagogue for 3 hours? She was there a few times. It's suffering sometimes, yeah? But you know, if you like it and it's part of your life, of your culture, you love it, yeah? Okay. Let's just repeat and finish with the first one. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamvorach. Now you are the crowd. Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam
Vaed.
That's it. That's the first part. Now, if he comes in the evening, weekday, to the synagogue, so it will be different. and how it will be in the synagogue in the evening prayer or in the morning prayer, because the, we have this bafu in the evening and in the morning. My God, how is it going bafu? Okay, I don't remember now the weekday, because we don't have so much minyanim on a weekday. I will continue with the Shabbat, which is more important. I will come back to the weekday after. But you have it if you look on sidurlive.com. Can you write it here? Can, shall I write it? Or on my Michael Dushinsky on the computer. sidurlive.com. Yeah? Then, if you put on your computer, sidurlive.com, you have it there? So if you look, I take the on the left side. Okay, we can maybe.
You can show the others.
Just put it. No, you, okay. I don't know how to use this. Ma'ariv. Ma'ariv and Havdalah. Yeah.
Okay. I'll put it on the computer.
Like Fredo was letting me
know. Ma'ariv and Havdalah.
Yeah.
And you can put it, and we can hear it. You'll be able to hear it, I think.
The first one? Or
no, the last one. Ma'ariv and Havdalah.
Aleinu let Shabbat.
No. Ah, the first, you got a moment? Ah, there, I will see it now here.
Maybe she will get it.
Yeah, here. Ma'ariv and Havdalah. And, yeah, you see Ma'ariv for weekdays?
Yeah.
So, put it. This is some verse which we say before. Now comes the Baruch Hu. Everyone please stop. Baruch Hu. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamorah. It was not like the first one, you have it recorded now. And then the community answer, Baruch Adonai Hamevorach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamevorach Leolam Vaed.
You have the words with me? Baruch Adonai Hamevorach Leolam Vaed. It's more beautiful than the one of the Bar Mitzvah,
yeah.
I think. No? I like it better. But you know, you have to be a good cantor to know it. And you see, for a minute I forgot it because I don't know when the last time that I had a minyan to pray Ma'ariv. You know what is a minyan? There's not so many possibilities in this town. You can have it on your phone and you can have it everywhere. Okay, now Baruch Hu of Shabbat, but we'll do it lively, it's better. From time to time maybe I'll ask you to use this, but now you see that before you go to the test, you can say, Rega moment, I want to check in Dushinsky's website. I worked very hard on it, and I recorded it in a about more than 10 years ago in a studio. You can hear it's quite a good recording. Okay, next Shabbat we did the Friday night, but we did not do the Friday night. Shabbat Friday night. Can you put Shabbat Friday night? Go back to the this. No, Ma'ariv, yeah. Baruch Hu, let's see. Bakasha.
Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach.
Everyone, Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach. But if you are a good cantor, you have a lot of place to play. Baruch Hu. That's what we call Nusach. It's holy. You must be there. But you can play with it. It's like Baroque music. Better. Huh? I think so. Anyway, go. I think so, no? It's beautiful. And the community, what they do?
Oh, Adonai HaMevorach Leolam Vaed. Adon Amor Leolam Leolam Vaen.
It's a different mode, a different atmosphere. You are already Friday night Shabbat. Now if you come on Shabbat and you do Baruchu et Adonai Amorach, that's okay. But if you do the one which we did a few minutes ago, Baruchu et Adonai Amorach for the Bar Mitzvah, this is not Shabbos. I run away from the synagogue. I'm not getting into the atmosphere. It must be. It's holy, and it must be like this. And that's what we call Nosaf, and it's very important. So we already did Bar Mitzvah, we did weekday, we did Friday night. Do you think that Shabbat morning will be the same like Friday night? No. It will be different. So make Shabbat morning. Sukkot is in Rosh Hashanah.
Shacharit,
Baruch. Blah blah blah. El Adon. Here. Yeah. But this will be.
Shochein
Ad. Move a little bit.
Marom.
Where is Moving? Yeah. Yeah. Now. A little bit more. Yeah. Here.
ויישתבח
קדיש
ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתפסה
This is one קדיש, look at the קדיש which you have
ויתעדר ויתעלה ויתהלל
שמי הקודשה במילה תברכו לילה
לילה מכל חטה ושירתה
תושבחתה sacrifice yourself to go to the synagogue, okay, after it usually there is a good kiddush with sholet, with wine, with whiskey, you know, but you have to wait until 11:30 or something. It's terrible, but we like it and we sing and it's a nice action there. And it depends really how the community knows the tune and how the cantor who leads the service is already just one of them. Knows it, and the more you know better how to sing it, the community more joins and enjoys it. So, what is the community answering? You have it. You don't have to take it away. You have the baruchu here, you know, so you can look here.
But baruchu, let me do it. Et Adonai Hamvorach,
community.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Vaed.
You say you catch it. You see? You are in the mood. But, and then the cantor must answer. I asked him before, why the cantor must repeat it? Because you cannot say Baruchu, you bless, and you don't do it yourself. And maybe you say, bless God, who is to be blessed. And you say, yes, God is blessed, and God who is blessed by us. God, blessed you. And then the Chazal does not repeat. Who knows what he said to himself, because usually no one sees it, yeah? They are behind him. Maybe at that time he blessed Jesus, so he must prove that he did not. Really, that's the reason, because it happened maybe, you know, when it all started. All this schism between the church and the Jews in the 3rd century. So he must say, Baruch Adonai, must repeat it loudly that everyone knows that he is not blessing some other gods. It can be idols, it can be Zarathustra, I don't know what. Zoroaster, how do you call it here? You know, it can be anything you want. It can be Augustus, Julius, you know that they made themselves gods? Do you know it? You don't know. Did you hear about Julius? Caesar?
Yeah.
Did you hear about Augustus Caesar? There were two mad people. They were great. Julius was killed, you know. Et tu, Brute. You know, the Julius Caesar, you know, Shakespeare. But both of them were a bit megalomans. And they decided that the month will be called after them. So 1 month until today is July, Julius. Not in Czech, of course, but in all other European languages. And the next month after July is Augustus. And Mr. Julius decided that he must make it 30 days. No, 31. Ah, it's not according to the order. Then Augustus came, I also make 31. That's just because they decided until today with this stupid calendar we continue. Januar, February, March, April, May, June, July, August. No? No logic. Just, I'm Julius. I'm Augustus. Anyway.
How logically is your calendar?
How did I do it?
No, how logically is Jewish calendar?
Oh yeah, very much, but that's a different lecture.
Okay.
I have it all written in English. I can send the email. I will send you a lecture of 2 pages,
so
4 pages.
It's more practical.
4 pages, very clear if you really learn it. But you have to go to the professor of mathematics if you have some problem. But it's not. I tried to make it very, I simplified it very much in this lecture. For Jews and for not Jews, believe me, yeah. So anyway, let's continue. We have already done a few Barchus. I think it's enough Barchus. Let's make some Kaddishim. You think, madam?
Yes, yes, yes.
I think.
Yes, please. How much time?
Shall I do Kaddishim now?
Something?
Okay. Okay. We can do more Barchus. I will just make for you some of them without you answering. There are two or three which are very important. There is one for 3 festivals. You have to remember them. Passover, Sukkot, Tabernacles, and Shavuot. It's called Pentecost in the Czech, you know. This one in April, the first one, when we went out from Egypt. The second one is just now, September, October, after the New Year. And Yom Kippur, and the third one is 50 days after. Penta is 50 plus. And then the Barchu of these 3 festivals is very beautiful and totally different. It goes like this. I make it the simplest version. There are more complicated versions. I make the simple. Baruchu et Adonai HaMevorach. Did you read the Frankish? It's nice, but you are only communist. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach, please. Baruch Adonai That's what we call Yom Tov. And then there is another one for Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Only Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, which means 3 nights. Only 2 nights of Rosh Hashanah, 1 of Yom Kippur, first night of Yom Kippur, after Kol Nidre. And usually in many communities, the community starts with this. Pilgrimage.